I used to think there were just two settings, male and female, but it's actually a lot sexier than that. A lot sexier than that. A lot sexier. There are lots of flavors to sexuality.
Oh, this again? Come on.
Now, I've spoken to some of you about my theories on the nature of being ice cream.
Which have no basis in science.
It's the science of feelings. And as vanilla, I feel that I am the most natural of the ice creams, and therefore the rest of you should just go ahead and also be vanilla.
No one can make you stop being strawberry, strawberry. You're strawberry!
Hold me, salted caramel!
One thing's clear about sexuality. There's a lot more going on than meets the eye. Female or male, gay or straight, pink or blue, we were taught to see these as binary. Now we're realizing it's more like a kaleidoscope. And this stuff isn't just for adults. Parents know this already. Kids explore gender, expression, attraction before they've ever heard of a spectrum. Take sex. We used to think it was pretty straightforward. X and a Y chromosome for males, two X's for females. But we see more combinations than that in real life. And even for people with just two sex chromosomes, hormones can vary wildly. So can anatomy. What makes someone male or female isn't so clear cut.
Look, I know that so many people are starting to catch this SJW virus, but I never knew that it would be my dearest Bill.
I'm a girl. Could have just as easily been a boy though, because the probability of becoming a girl is always 1 in 2. See, inside each of our cells are these things called chromosomes, and they control whether we become a boy or a girl. Your mom has 2X chromosomes in all of her cells, and your dad has 1X and 1Y chromosome in each of his cells. Before you're born, your mom gives you one of her chromosomes and your dad gives you one of his. Mom XX, a girl, or XY, a boy. The chance of becoming either a boy or a girl is always 1 in 2. A 50-50 chance either way. It's like flipping a coin. Mm-hmm. X, you're a girl, Y, you're a boy. Some people are just lucky, I guess.
I am so sorry to my world. I am so sorry to my world. This is not what we want.
Oh, my God. All right, I just can't deal anymore.
Consider the following.
XX, a girl, or XY, a boy.
So, you guys, seriously, this next thing I feel is very special. This is a cool little segment. You know this woman from Crazy Ex-Girlfriend. Please give it up for Rachel Bloom.
Ours is full of choice, but must I choose between only John or Joyce? All my options only, hard or moist. My vagina has its own voice.
A lot sexier than that.
Say that some people don't have privilege when you basically just said that trans people aren't valid. They're not a thing. They're just girls pretending to be boys or boys pretending to be girls.
Mm, okay.
Like,
oh, someone's excited. Okay.
Biological, but gender is a completely different thing.
No, gender is not disconnected from sex. So
it's not completely disconnected, but it's still a cultural thing. It's still from society. It's
okay. No, it is not in the mind. Okay, you're not a man if you think you're a man. And I didn't say pretending, or if I did, I shouldn't have said pretending. Let me amend.
You said playing.
Okay, I said a boy who thinks he's a girl. That's the usual phraseology I use. not playing. I usually say a boy who thinks he's a girl or a girl who thinks he's a boy, which is technically what we're talking about here. As far as the actual psychological issues at play, it used to be called gender dysphoria or gender identity disorder. Now they call it gender dysphoria. The idea that sex or gender are malleable is not true.
Within sexology, everybody knows what the truth is, but...
Okay, and I'm not denying your humanity if you're a transgender person. I am saying that you are not the sex to which you claim to be. You're still a human being, and you're a human being with an issue that I wish you Godspeed in dealing with in whatever way you see fit. But if you are going to dictate to me that I'm supposed to pretend that men are women and women are men, no. My answer is no. I'm not going to modify basic biology because it threatens your subjective sense of what you are.
Within sexology, everybody knows what the truth is, but...
Okay, but you're still saying these kids should, not be accepted because they don't really fit in either place? They can't just,
I'm saying that the Boy Scouts have a standard. You must be a biological boy to be a Boy Scout. You have to be a boy to be a Boy Scout.
Where's that written, though?
Okay. In the name Boy Scouts. Because this is a very...
Okay,
because for all of human history, boy meant boy and girl meant girl. Boy did not mean girl. And if I call you a moose, are you suddenly a moose? Okay, if I redefine our terms. No, yes, that's right. Men and women are a completely different thing. This is true. Have you ever met a man or a woman? They're completely different.
You can't say you're a cat. It's not a thing. It's genders. It's not saying you're...
Okay, why is that? I don't understand. Why? Okay, let me ask you this. I will ask you how old you are, okay? Because you're young enough that it's probably not insulting to ask you. So...
I'm 22, so I'm probably naive, right?
No. Why aren't you 60? Why aren't you 60?
Within sexology, everybody knows what the truth is, but...
And why... Why can't you identify as 60? Why? What is the problem with you identifying as 60?
It's the same as gender. You can't just...
You're right. Age is significantly less important than gender. You can't magically change your gender. You can't magically change your sex. You can't magically change your age.
You can still legally change it. People recognize...
You can't legally change your age, by the way.
Obviously. You can change your name, you can change your sex, you can change your identity.
Just because you can do things legally doesn't mean that they are correct biologically. You could do lots of things in the past that were incorrect biologically and incorrect legally. For a long period of time in the United States, sterilization of the mentally ill took place. That didn't make it okay. Skinner versus Oklahoma. Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes wrote the decision.
Right. I still don't understand how you're
It's not a matter of open-minded and accepting. I want them to get treatment that they see fit, but that's not involving me. The idea behind the transgender movement as a civil rights movement is the idea that all of their problems would just go away if I would pretend that they were the sex to which they claim membership. That's nonsense. The transgender suicide rate is 40%. It is 40%.
The single most common question I get asked is, are you a boy or are you a girl? The simple answer is no. But then the response after that is usually a very confused, what?
Within sexology, everybody knows what the truth is, but...
So here is the explanation. I am non-binary, and that means I identify as something other than male or female. Our society and history has led us to believe over thousands of years that there are only people who are male and people who are female. But that is because past society has based gender on physical sex. It's outdated.
Within sexology, everybody knows what the truth is, but...
The truth is that gender is in the brain, and physical sex is a completely separate and different thing that is private to every individual. What people really mean when they're asking the boy or girl question is creepily, so, what genitals do you have?
People were ignorant about what the reality is, or that they choose to only present one side of the story, because it's obviously a lot more, you get more pats on the back if you play along with the narrative. So I knew writing that op-ed that people were going to get upset, but I felt it was really important to put that information out there because within sexology, everybody knows what the truth is, but...
Educated on genetics.
Would you like to discuss the genetics or
your
genetics,
sir? I'd stay away from the genetics and back to the brain scans.
You cut that out now or you'll go home in an ambulance.
Within sexology, everybody knows what the truth is, but...
Out now or you'll go home in an ambulance.
Within sexology, everybody knows what the truth is, but...
2017 Nye's fraudulent posing as an expert on science has been pointed out for years. Here are a few examples of his scientific intelligence. 1. Arguing to Dan Rather that the more heat in the atmosphere, the stronger hurricanes are, confusing the atmosphere with the oceans. 2. Likening a New England mega blizzard to Hurricane Sandy, and implying both storms originated off the coast from Africa. As Jason Salmanow of the Washington Post noted, Sandy formed in the Caribbean not from an African wave, and the blizzard formed off the mid-Atlantic coast from the merger of two North American disturbances. Salmanow added, Nye then draws an absurd comparison between East Coast storms and West Coast storms in an attempt to equate them. Salmanow commented that Nye's rhetoric was one of the most flawed discussions of meteorology I've ever seen on a national network. 3. Nye posted a video regarding abortion in 2015 in which he argued that the pro-life position is false because many, 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 many more hundreds of eggs are fertilized than become humans, ignoring that humans are formed at fertilization. As the Daily Wire pointed out, his video was debunked here, here and here. 4. Positing that quantum entanglement could pave the way for time travel, a concept that was eviscerated by Forbes's Chad Orzel. John Coleman, the founder of the Weather Channel. I have always been amazed that anyone would pay attention to Bill Nye.